our defense was in great depths, and with the exception of both the tank battalions and my own 4th battalion, was able to withstand the effects of the bombardment. Major Becker's battalion was very well trained men and excellent equipment, and using orchard and villages in a very intelligent way had a great effect in this battle.
First of all, I must congratulate Colonel von Luck on his handling of the defense. It was tenacious, remarkably flexible, and their recovery from the enormous bombing effort was quite remarkable. Now, as to ourselves, let us just look at the instructions issued by General Montgomery for this operation. We were given certain objectives. Well, we only got one of those. That was Bra Hubert Folly. Then we were to enlarge the existing bridgehead over the Orne. That was done to the extent of 10 miles from the start point, which gave a very fine base for further operations. Then we were to write down enemy armor and equipment. As far as we can discover, the enemy casualties were 75 tanks and SP guns and over 2,000 men. Then, and perhaps the most important of all, we were to attract to the Second Army front the bulk of the German armor so that the Americans would have an easier run from their breakout over to the west. That, I believe, was the most important objective of Goodwood. And I would ask you to look particularly at those heavy tank battalions which you have heard about from von Rosen. Perhaps all our hopes of Goodwood were not completely successful, but judged by the overall situation, it was by no means a failure.
Perhaps the last word should come from Commander-in-Chief West, Field Marshal von Kluger, in his dispatch to Hitler on the day Goodwood ended.
My discussion yesterday with the commanders in the Caen sector has afforded regrettable evidence that in face of the enemy's complete command of the air, there is no possibility of our finding a strategy which will counterbalance its truly annihilating effect, unless we give up the field of battle. In spite of our intense efforts, the moment has drawn near when this front, already so heavily strained, will break. And once the enemy is in open country, an orderly command will be hardly practicable in view of the insufficient mobility of our troops. I consider it my duty to bring these conclusions to your notice, my Führer, in good time.
On the 25th of July, the weather which had held up Operation Cobra since the 21st of July relented, and preceded by an air and artillery bombardment even greater than that at Goodwood, the American First Army attacked. By the 26th, they had advanced only 4,000 yards, but they were through the prepared defenses. By the 27th, the breakout had been achieved. The sacrifice at Goodwood had brought its reward, and the original plan conceived by General Montgomery was put into effect.